Randall, hi, it's Rebecca. Something strange is going on at the science center where I work. Two of my colleagues died recently, and today the body of a scientist, Howard Morrison, was found in the greenhouse. It is said that Howard suffocated after breathing in the spores of some poisonous flowers that the scientists used to make antidotes. I'm sure it's a murder, but no one believes me. Everyone thinks that it's just an accident, and it does look that way. If it weren't for one thing, the greenhouse was locked from the outside and with an electronic lock. Howard couldn't have locked himself in from the inside, right? And when his body was discovered, that door was still locked from the outside with the sealing code activated. That can only mean it was premeditated murder. The police looked through the security camera footage but didn't see anyone on it. I know you are a talented detective and would be willing to help both the science center and me, your good friend. I'm really afraid that I might be the next victim.
Just like old times, Randall? How about you search the place and look for evidence while I question all the staff?
Thank you. Gloves and lab coat are here. It also seems that he wore a respirator, but is not around, as if it had been pulled off. Doesn't look like an accidental death. The deceased often worked until late, when no one else was in the lab. A perfect opportunity to kill him. records are clean. Only the lab workers can come here. Either it was one of them, or the killer somehow managed to sneak in after Howard. Police have already checked all the traces. They belong to Howard himself. So either there was no killer, or somehow the killer became invisible.
That I gave you for your birthday to find out one of the murderer's traits from his dossier. I'll send it to you right now. Thank you.
Thank you. Randall, I found something. Only Tobias Black really has a motive for murder.
Great. Thanks, sis. I'll find his address in the database and drive to his house.